Hello, my soccer universe. Yes, this post's late, and yes, yesterday there was no video. As I said, I'm entering vacation mode, and today we had tons to do. Yesterday after the match, I just wanted to go to bed. So yeah, I'm doing this now in the late afternoon. I will post in the evening, but fortunately there's no games this evening, and we have the big final tomorrow, which I'm actually looking forward to. The game yesterday between Tunisia and Nigeria, was not all that great. Most importantly, Nigeria could play in these bad boys, even though if they were the away team. Tunisia decided to play in red, which I thought was fine. I liked the matchup better than I would have liked white against the dark green, to be honest. It was something different to see. I also think for colorblind people, this was not as bad of a matchup because this is a very light green, so I don't think there are many people in the colorblind area would have had problems. Speaking of colorblind, and that's more or less a joke, I have observed that at the AFCON, when you see in the display, they give below the teams, they give kind of the color that they play in, but sometimes it's often. Yesterday for Nigeria in the second half, suddenly Nigeria was shown that they play in yellow. Just note that. If you see highlights, note that. It's really bizarre how they come up in those colors. Anyway, the game was nothing much to talk about. I mean, the game started with Nigeria going forward. Collins puts a cross in, and then the goalkeeper, Thurston goalkeeper, Ben Sharifia, and Yassine Meria don't know what they want to do. The goalkeeper wants to clear, plays it on to the defender, goes back to the goalkeeper. In the end, it falls to Ighalo, who can make it all in the third minute, 1-0. And yeah, then there was not much coming. The game was really slow paced. You know, it is the seventh game. It is still played in enormous heat. And I think when I do my summary of the AFCON, this will be for me the biggest negative is that it's played, that this AFCON was played in extreme heat in Egypt. I don't think it would have been much better in Cameroon. But you know, if you give it to South Africa in the Southern Hemisphere, you might actually get a decent tournament, potentially. I mean, yes, the players are all tired. Sassi had a good chance to equalize in the 15th, and I think that was basically it in the first half, where I think Nigeria had a little bit more of the game, but as I said, that was really a bad game. Right after the half, Firas Shawat came on for Tunisia and had a really good chance in the 47th. I even remember telling my wife, oh, goal, goal. No, it was not. It went to the outer net. I really thought he will make this goal. And that was all that Tunisia was showing, because the only other chance around the 60th was for Samuel Chukwueze, who really had a nice shot that was just saved by the goalkeeper outside of the corner. It might have hit the corner if it, I think, more than going in. And then it was already in stoppage time when Samuel Kalou comes on. Yeah, speaking of coming on, Ighalo, who is probably the top scorer for this tournament with 5 goals. I don't think anyone will take this away from him unless someone goes really nuts in the final, which I doubt. So he comes off at halftime with a hamstring injury. And then, yeah, Kalou comes on in the 90th for Chukwueze to take a free kick. That was already really dangerous. It was kind of took a very wicked turn, goalkeeper was on his spot, and then another chance like that, and it ends 1-0 for Nigeria. So the Super Eagles win their 7th or 8th third place game at the AFCON, which is a pretty impressive record. I mean, the other thing that I have to say is, made clear to me from the home commentator, Nigeria has 190 million people. That's a huge nation. There's huge potential there. If they can harness this potential, they could be a veritable superpower. It's gotta be said. I mean, there are many players that play soccer there. The other thing that has to be said, this was a really young Nigeria team. I think, and I hope that Gernot Rohr can stay with these guys, because I think he's building a great team that could be threatening for 22 or the next AFCON. I think there's an AFCON next year. If there's not next year, it's in 2 years, but I think there was an AFCON next year. Let me quickly check on that. No, there's an AFCON in 2 years. I think then, played in Cameroon, you would think that Nigeria is heavily favored, or could be heavily favored by that time. depending on how stable it is. We saw already that Clarence Seedorf was fired by Cameroon. What can I say? You gotta give the coaches time, and in Africa they don't have the patience still. So that's always a downside. Not, as I said, and it's personal, only from personal experience, I think that Clarence Seedorf is a really smart guy, and if he's given the right chance, I think he can be brilliant. Just he doesn't get the chances, and that's a shame because he is a really smart football man. I will always say that. Well, that's it. I'm not sure if there will be a video tomorrow, but I will sure post a video after the final. It might take a little bit, but we'll get there to make a really nice roundup, and then thereafter I will make my summary video for the AFCON, and then I'm going on vacation. Up until then, bye. Hey there, I really hope you enjoyed this video, and if you did, here are some videos and playlists that might be of interest to you too. Also, please consider subscribing to my channel, as it will give you all the updates on my channel, all things My Soccer Universe. And with that, I want to wish you a wonderful day.